Nobody is better to represent an area than a hometown son who knows the area, grew up in the area, their family grew up in the area, their family's family grew up in the area. This is your backyard and then some. Welcome to the show. And you've announced your intention to run for 8th Congressional District today.
I did, yes, ma'am. Thanks for having me on the show.
Of course.
This is an exciting time.
Very exciting time. The thing that I... And I've told people before, I don't normally do campaign anything, really. I mean, but one of the reasons why I am so, I think that your race represents a larger story. I think that your announcing that you're going to run represents a bigger theme here. And because you don't really want to. And I always think that the person who doesn't really want to and is doing it begrudgingly because they know that there's a job that's got to get done, and they know that no one else is going to really be able to do it adequately, and they just want a good job done so that they can go back and live their life. That's the type of person that you want to be running and to be in the seat. And that's kind of your mentality. Yeah, that's like where you're coming from. You're like, well, I guess if nobody else can, then I'm going to have to do it and just roll up the shirt sleeves.
It was time, and I feel compelled, and it's a necessity, especially being a hometown boy. And when Congressman Brady decided to retire, which was such an amazing man, my family and friends in the district and here where we grew up, I started getting phone calls. And again, it was one of the more challenging decisions I had made, but my family and I chatted about it an extended period of time, and we prayed on it. And inevitably, I'm running for Congress for the exact same reason I served in the military, and that's to serve my country.
Yeah.
You know, to protect and support the Constitution of the United States, and I'm all in.
Yeah, absolutely. For those who want to know more about Morgan's background, obviously you have a brother who's your identical twin, Marcus, and your
younger brother.
I'm going to make a note of that to always your little baby, sweet little baby brother. I'll just put it like that.
That's right.
But Morgan Luttrell, for those who don't know, he got his bachelor's in psychology. You served multiple deployments in combat, naval special warfare officer. You were also in a helicopter crash in 2009. And you had really a huge, huge hurdle that you had to get over. Tell us a little bit about that. How do you think that this prepared you? Because this is obviously a different kind of fire. It's like, I don't know which one's the frying pan and which one's the fire sometimes. But tell us a little bit about that and how that's kind of set your perspective on dealing with this kind of stuff, like with the craziness that we're seeing in D.C.
Oh, yes, ma'am. That's a great question and great perspective. Like you alluded to, after my helicopter crash, I broke my back and destroyed everything from the waist down. It was actually the traumatic brain injury that was the hardest, where I was hardest hit, if you will, just because back in those days, back in 2009, we didn't have our head around like we do now,
right?
Brain science. So the physical injuries were easy to get around. New legs, arms, liver, lungs, medical science, technology, they have that down pretty good. We can bring you back to baseline, but it was the head injury that was very challenging for me. And I went to work on it. I really wanted to figure out how to get myself back to baseline and above, because at that level in spec war, especially the SEAL teams, you need to be at an operational tempo or an operational level that just far exceeds expectations. And I had to be able to do that, especially as a naval officer.
Yes, yes. 14-year military career.
Yes, ma'am. 8 years enlisted and 7 as an officer, right at 7. So...
Wow.
I would say that prepared me just because of the adversity and the challenges that I was faced with. And that really compelled me to get into academia after I was medically retired from the military. And my passion is brain science and helping veterans that have post-traumatic stress and traumatic brain injury, addiction problems. So I would say my background, and I also worked in D.C. for Secretary Perry in the Trump administration. So I have D.C. experience as well. And I learned early on when I walked into D.C. that they really don't care who you are, where you're from, just as long as you are able to navigate the difficult waters of D.C. and get things done, which I was able to do.
Yeah, you were. You mentioned Secretary Perry. Of course, everybody knows him, Governor Rick Perry. He appointed you. You served as special advisor, and that was in the Department of Energy there. And now this is where I always think, I mean, it's very providential. I always think that there are certain people he doesn't call the equip, he equips the called, and that there are certain people that rise up to fit certain needs at certain times. And this is where just all the pieces coming together like this seems kind of stunning to me, because he was asking you to lead the creation of artificial intelligence and technologies office, because we needed to make sure that the United States can stay ahead of Russia and China when we're talking about technology and machine learning technology. And here we're dealing with, we just had the ransomware attack on our biggest gas line, the Colonial Pipeline. There was another, not ransomware, but it was another cyber attack on one of the biggest meatpacking plants in the world. And now everyone's talking about beef prices going up. A headline came out today that China was trying to unsuccessfully hack into New York's subway system. The battlefield is changing the more technologically sophisticated we become, and we need people who understand this in positions where they are able to make decisions that help national security and the protection of Americans. And you, quite literally, this is like your wheelhouse. Talk to us about that.
It is. And people, I really want people to understand that that the cyber attack on the Colonial Pipeline and the JPS meat factory, that those are 9/11 size attacks without the body count. And I don't have a better way to put that. That's how I have to articulate that, because in 2021, and the amount of money that China and Russia are pumping into their artificial intelligence and the machine learning technologies, if America doesn't take a hard look, which in my opinion, the seated administration is not, we cannot afford to fall behind in the AI space. Because make no mistake about it, it's not going to be a bomb, a plane, a rifle further downrange when these wars start. If you have the ability to reach across the pond, if you will, and a click of a button, shut down our infrastructure, hit our grid, shut down the subway, you shut down Wall Street for an hour, the ripple effect, you can't quantify it. It's unmeasurable. And it's a very sensitive but scary topic. And
it is.
That's one of my biggest campaign platforms. We need to take a hard look at cybersecurity. We need to move in that direction. And I learned that firsthand working in D.C. and seeing our America's capabilities. We're there. It just seems like when this administration came in, they went a completely different direction. And it's disheartening, especially as hard as we work under the Trump administration and Secretary Perry to get that started.
Yeah. And this is, and it you mentioned something important. I mean, it's a scary thing, because I think so many people know too little about it. And I've always said that it seems like cybersecurity is kind of treated like the condiment on the buffet, right? It's like, it's kind of an afterthought, but that's where everything is moving towards. And we got some people in Congress that I know that they have good intentions, but I think that some of the folks don't quite understand exactly the best way to go about, you know, making sure that like our grid is secured and making sure that our pipelines, that's infrastructure, to talk about infrastructure. But I we need more of that. We need more people that have your thinking.
We do. Yeah, I totally agree. Thank you for saying that.
Well, of course.
It's necessary. It's an absolute necessity. Then we take a hard look at what is happening and what has happened. I mean, we want to be energy dependent. That's energy independent. I mean, that's the best thing we have. We shut down a pipeline right when the administration sees. We have a colonial pipeline attack. I mean, we just got out of a pandemic, and we're not even looking at being medically independent. I mean, what happened? We depended so much on overseas products to make the American public healthy. I mean, we got the virus from them.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah, we all of our, what is it, our PPE majorly came from them, antibiotics, some antivirals, and then not to say nothing about like the chips and the rare earth elements, etc. All of this. People can go. We're talking with Morgan Luttrell, who announced today that he is running for Congress, Texas's 8th congressional district. And you can visit his website, morganluttrell.com. And your background with cybersecurity and as well as serving your country on the battlefront as well. I mean, you have your priorities listed. I mean, for the folks that are wondering, he checks all of the limited government boxes, protecting the Second Amendment, border security, cutting wasteful spending, which is, you know, there's several things that are right there at the center of my heart. But one of the things that I think you really, really get more so than a lot of people, because I know that we live in very, very politically tribal times, is you get the bigger picture, because this isn't really Democrat and Republican anymore, liberal versus conservative. You have members of Congress that are openly advocating for Marxist principles and Marxist economic policy, and even using language to promote it. We are in this, you know, the Marxism versus liberty kind of phase of things now. And you're one of the few people who kind of see around all of the, you know, the political benchmarks and get that bigger picture. Talk to me a little bit about that, because that really, that's how coalitions are formed.
It is. I've seen firsthand what that looks like in other places in the world. I've been around this world. I've fought in a lot of places. And I again, see firsthand that if we don't create a defensive posture, a strong defensive posture right now, and say no more. Hmm. We need people in D.C. that have the ability to stand up for what is right and our conservative values and say no more and have a voice and be confident.
Hmm.
And not be scared, not be frightened. I've had people try to do amazingly bad things to me. So if you're going to throw some harsh language out, you got to have to come at me with something harder than that.
There you go. He's been insulted by better.
Yeah, I've been insulted by better. I've sat in front of OMB before. It was a nightmare. Anyway.
Wow.
So it's a slippery slope that we're on. And I really want the American public to know, hey, look, this. However you're thinking, you need to really dig into and see the underpinnings of what these people are preaching, because it could scuttle a country. Mm-hmm. And if we get too far downstream and can't swim, we're done.
Yeah. It's a scary time, and a scary time calls for some brave folks. Morgan Luttrell, the website's morganluttrell.com, announces run for Texas's 8th Congressional District. Morgan, I know we'd love to have you back and talk to you more, especially as we get further and further into, you know, the ransomware attacks, the cybersecurity, because these headlines now, I mean, I think the Colonial Pipeline opened up a whole wave of stuff. One company capitulated and, you know, our government sort of stood to the side. And now that's just emboldening all these other people. So now we're hearing all of these other stories now about attempts and whether they're successful or not. So we're really going to need to rely upon your expertise. I know you're running for Congress, but we're going to need to rely on your expertise as well on this.
No, happy to. Look forward to it.
Awesome.